Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about a derivation which is based on the expansion of a gas isothermally and irreversibly at constant pressure. So let us talk about it. So now we are going to talk about the derivation for the work done during expansion of a gas at constant pressure, and this is the work done which is been done in an irreversible process. So for that, let us consider a certain amount of gas at pressure P having a volume of V1 and a temperature T, which is enclosed in a cylinder fitted with a frictionless movable piston of area A. So for that instance, I have drawn a diagram so that it would be very much easier to understand. So this is the diagram that I have drawn. So basically this is the cylinder that we have considered of the cross section area, that is A. And in this case, the gas has been enclosed, so therefore the gas has been present in it, while this is nothing but the frictionless piston. And the gas is been occupying the volume of V1. So therefore, this is the volume which it has been occupied. So I would write it here as V1. So this is the data that we have. And yes, all the gas that has been mentioned in this case, suppose if I'm considering the gas, and the gas will be having a constant temperature. So in this case, I would write here that the temperature is constant. It is not changed, but the gas which is enclosed in a cylinder over a frictionless piston, as you could see. So in this case, basically the gas will have a particular pressure. So therefore, the pressure of the gas which is inside the cylinder is nothing but P, as well as the piston is also above it. So what will happen is the piston will try to enclose it, and so this is the pressure that gas will apply to the piston so as to remain constant, so as to remain the volume should be constant at V1. So this is the thing that we have talked about at a normal condition, means when the gas is not being expanding. So this is a normal condition of a gas which will have a pressure of P, which will have a volume of V1, and having a cross section where the cylinder has a cross section area of A, which will be the fixed thing, and yes, this is the piston. The temperature is also being maintained constant. So what happens if the gas expands? Because we are discussing about the work done during the expansion of gas at constant temperature. And at constant pressure. So as we could see, suppose if the gas expands, so the first thing that we are going to observe is that the volume will increase. So, but before the volume will, we know that the volume will increase. But the main thing that we should know is the gas will expand. In this case, the pressure which is being applied from the frictionless piston towards the gas, it will try to pull the gas towards inside, means it will try to make the piston towards downside. But since the gas has been expanding, so the gas will oppose the external pressure. So in this case, the pressure that is being applied from the piston is nothing but, I'm denoting it by PEX, that is the pressure. So the work will only be done if external pressure is applied or if opposing pressure is being applied. So the work will only be done when the pressure, that is the external pressure, is applied, and then only the expansion of gas is possible. Because in vacuum also, suppose in vacuum there is no pressure, so what will happen, the gas will try to expand automatically, as well as the piston will move up. But that doesn't mean the gas has performed good. It has, because of the pressure. Because of the pressure is zero, that's the reason the gas was been expanding. So now we are going to talk about the work done by the during the expansion of gas. So for that reason, we have to maintain that the external pressure plays a very vital role. So how? Let me tell you. So we know that is work is nothing but, if the work has been done by the system to the surrounding, then the work, I'm denoting it by W. So it will be equals to basically opposing force into displacement. So the work is nothing but the opposing force into displacement. But this was the diagram which was based when the gas is present in normal condition. Suppose if the gas expands. If the gas expands, then the one thing is sure, that the volume will change. So in this case, suppose the piston, when the piston is present in this position at a normal condition, before expansion of gas, then the volume is V1. So suppose if the gas expands, then obviously the piston will move up. So this is the thing where suppose piston have moved to this distance, that is the displacement. I have made it the displacement as D, or the height that has changed from this position to this position is D. So now new volume will be appearing. New volume will be appeared. So this was the initial volume at normal condition, but F, as if the gas expanded or as if the piston moved upwards. So this will be the new volume, that is V2. So this V1 is nothing but the initial volume, while this V2 is nothing but the final volume after expansion of gas. So in this thing, what we observe is, we observe that this is the displacement that was done after the expansion of gas. So now we could again come back to this equation, where W is nothing but opposing force into displacement. But the opposing force, let me denote the opposing force as F into the displacement, which is nothing but D. So this is the force, but the force is opposite. Why? Because as we could see that the gas has been expanding, and it has been expanding by opposing the force which is applied on it, and the force which is being applied on it is nothing but the pressure. So basically this F will be nothing but minus F, and the negative sign is because of the gas is expanding and it is resisting the opposing force. That's the reason the negative sign is here. So minus F into D. But what is F actually? What is force? We know that force is nothing but pressure into area, or we could say is as pressure is nothing but force upon a unit area, or force divided by area is nothing but pressure itself. So we know that force is been denoted by F, while the pressure P and the area of cross section, that is the area of cylinder, it is, I'll keep it as A. But talking about the pressure, there are two kinds of pressure, as you could say, that one is the pressure of gas, while one is the external pressure applied by the surrounding to the system, so that the system would compress, but the gas has been expanding. So this gas is opposing the pressure which is applied through the surrounding. So therefore, this pressure is nothing but the external pressure. So the force is applied to the external pressure so that the gas would expand. So what I'm going to do is, I am introducing this equation in equation number one. So what I would get, therefore, W is equals to minus PEX. PEX is nothing but the external pressure into A, as we could see, area of cross section or area of the cylinder, and D is the height. So this is the equation that we have got, but this is not the final equation that we have derived. The thing is, Px, which is nothing but the external pressure, and when we are talking about A into D, so this A into D, that is the area of cross section of the cylinder, basically this area, and I have drawn it in a 2D diagram, but actually it would be a cylinder. So therefore, this area of cross section multiply by the height, or multiply by the height. If even suppose if this is the area, again we could say that this piston will also has an area of A. So this area into displacement will nothing but the volume, but this volume has appeared because of the height when the piston was from original position to the final position. So this kind of difference between the volume that we have observed makes it as A into D as the change in volume. So basically, A into D, that is area into displacement, is nothing but the volume or the change in volume that we have observed. So I could write this equation as A into D is nothing but change in volume. Or I would write it as, because it is change in volume, we denote the change. Whenever we represent a change, we always use delta symbol. So this is delta and we have made a change in volume, or we could see change in volume. So therefore, I am representing it by delta V. But the change in volume is nothing but V2 minus V1, because the change is from final state to the minus the initial state. So in this case, delta V can be represented as V2 minus V1. But we have already made an equation here where W is equal to minus PEX, that is the external pressure, into A into D. And instead of A into D, what we are going to substitute? Yes, we are going to substitute delta V. So therefore, W is equals to, that is the work done by the system, is equals to, that is external pressure, instead of A into D, I will write it as delta V. Therefore, W can also be written as P external pressure into V2 minus V1. So this is the final derivation that we have made. And yes, this is basically the work done during the expansion of the S. And yes, here we can clearly see that the work is dependent on the change. That is true. But it is also dependent on the external pressure. So it is not depends on the pressure of the gas which has been present in the initial state, but it will depend on the pressure, or that is the opposing force, basically the pressure that we say. It depends on the external pressure. If the external pressure is more, then more work can be done during the expansion of the gas. And if the pressure, the external pressure is zero, then it will turn into, the work will won't be done because the work would be zero. So in this case, what we have got to know that the work depends on the external pressure. So in that case, basically I have made three conditions where we could say that what work would be done if the pressure is zero, or if there is no change in volume. So that is what I am going to explain it now. So this was the final thing, final derivation. So doing some extra effort in this case, so what we can observe is that when the process has a constant pressure, so what happens? That is when the pressure is being kept constant. So basically, in isobaric process, as we know that the pressure is constant, so therefore the work will be, yes, the W will be minus PEX into delta V. So therefore in that case, there won't be any change in the work. The work will remain the same. But when we are talking about an isochoric process, so what happens then? So when the system is under an isochoric process, then we know that isochoric process means the one where the volume doesn't change. So therefore in this case, delta V will be zero. But the formula is that W is equals to minus PEX into delta V. Since delta V, or that there is no change in volume, the volume will remain constant. So how the work would be done? Because the work will only be done when the gas expands. So if the piston is being occupying or the gas has been occupying a constant volume and it doesn't changes, so how it will be expand? And if the gas won't expand, then how the piston will move up? Or basically there will be no work done in that process. So therefore in that case, in isochoric process, W will be zero. There would be no work done. And finally, when we are talking that what will happen in vacuum, so basically in vacuum, as you know, there is no pressure. So therefore in that case, P, that is the external pressure, will also be zero in that case. So therefore what we could write as, again, W, which is nothing but minus PEX into delta V. In this case, since the external pressure is zero, overall the work will also be zero. So this were the three conditions when it is an isobaric process, when it is an isochoric process, and yes, when the work has been, or when we do work or during expansion of gas in vacuum condition. But there is one more thing that we should know, is that There are some sign conventions of the work, and what are those? Let me tell you. We have got to know that W is equals to minus PEX into, I will write it as V2 minus V1. So in this case, as we see that suppose V2 is greater than V1. This is only possible if the gas is being expanded. So if gas is being expanded, obviously that the final volume will be more, that is V2 will be always be more compared to that of the V1. So in this case, what will happen? The overall W will be minus itself. This is because the W will be minus. It showcases that when W is negative, when actually this will be when V2 is greater than V1, then the W will be negative. This W, which has a value of negative, that is the work when done is negative, when we get a negative value, this indicates that the system has done work on the surrounding, and that's the reason the gas has been expanded opposing the surroundings pressure, that is external pressure, then only the work has been done. So in this case, the work will be negative, we'll get a negative value. While that, when what happens if we know that the work is basically PEX into V2 minus V1. What if V1 is greater than V2? If V1 is greater than V2, it is only possible if the gas has been compressed. So the piston will move more downwards. So in this case, what happens actually, the external pressure is more than that of the pressure of the gas which is present in the which is present in the cylinder. So what happens is actually the gas will not expand, it will compress. So this allows the surrounding to apply more pressure so that the gas will compress, and in this case surrounding is been acting on the system, which makes, as we know, that V1 is greater than V2. So this value will be negative itself. So negative into negative, it will be positive. So ultimately we'll get the work which is basically positive. So there are two cases where we have got to know when W is negative and W is positive. So this clearly indicates when the W is when we get a value of W as a negative. So means system is acting on the surrounding, or the work is done and on the by the system to the surrounding, and when W is being positive, then this work is done by the surrounding to the system. So this clearly indicates that work is basically dependent on the pressure also, as well as the volume also, and hence this kind of work is known as pressure volume work. So this was the thing that I wanted to showcase you. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this concept very clearly, and meet you next time. And yes, share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.